Eddie Brennan has stepped away as manager of Laois after two seasons in charge, and that has to come as a massive blow to Laois. They released a statement on his behalf which said, "On behalf of the Laois senior hurling management team, I wish to inform you we will be stepping down and not going forward for 2021 season. We would like to thank all persons concerned that we worked with over the last 2 years, and in particular the players who gave us great efforts and dedication. We would like to wish everybody associated with Laois GAA the best in the future and wish them every success. Eddie Brennan and Niall Corcoran and Tommy Fitzgerald," who were of course part of his backroom team as well. And like, interestingly enough, the tweet that came out from Laois GAA is that they're disappointed. So their statement, they did a quote tweet of the statement and wrote, "Laois GAA is disappointed that our outgoing management team has decided not to commit for 2021. Laois GAA wish to thank Eddie, Niall and Tommy for their dedication and excellent work for the past 2 years. Laois GAA will meet shortly to formalise the process for the next appointment." So you would imagine that people across Laois are fairly appalled with what's happened, and so much of this goes back to, I mean, you can't ignore it at this stage. I don't think anyone really wanted to talk about it that publicly, but of course that off the record interview got out there and it did the rounds massively and went all around the GAA circles, every WhatsApp group going had it. People who don't really follow hurling all that closely or are all that interested in Laois GAA were sending it around and talking about it, and I think many hurling people would have probably had this sent to them 20 times in different WhatsApp groups. That's just the way that things go in the modern world. But so it's so disappointing that if that's the reason that Eddie and his management team have left, that it's because of something that had nothing to do with hurling and their performance. And I'm not saying that it was something that was in any way nefarious. I think it was a simple case of the recorder should have been turned off when the interview was done. After that, I think it was a case of it was sent to the person to upload and it should have been cut out. But in the first place, the recorder needs to go off as soon as it's done. Now, mistakes can happen. I think it probably, I feel like it wasn't anything intentional, nothing nasty done in it. But unfortunately, the shockwaves from it are huge. And, you know, like we all say things in an off the record setting. So we know how dangerous it can be if that gets out. So that, if that has is the reason that this has happened, that's unbelievably disappointing for Laois. They're heading in the right direction. In 2019, a first All-Ireland quarter-final in 40 years after beating Dublin in that qualifier. And what a day that was in Port Laois. The place was absolutely rocking, heaving. I remember talking to one of the local journalists, Stephen Miller, and he was saying that you could just see kids everywhere wearing Laois jerseys, even just before and after that. And the kids all around the streets. And they'd won the Joe McDonagh Cup. And this is only a couple of years after Laois had looked like a bit of a joke shop. I mean, there are obviously people who were trying to turn things around, and Cheddar Plunkett had got them fairly close and to making a bit of a breakthrough and almost beating Galway there a number of years ago. But it felt like this was something sustainable, building towards a future, progressive management team. And now where to for Laois? The fact that they're disappointed, the fact that there's a short off season. So how do you quickly turn it around and find a new manager? There'll obviously be people out there, but someone with Eddie's experience at this stage, the respect he commands, all that kind of stuff, it's going to be hard to find someone of that caliber. And of course there's going to be no shortage of people looking to get Eddie on board with their team. Now it remains to be seen what happens with the county teams in the coming season, but no doubt there'll be club teams up and down the country looking for him. His pedigree isn't really to be questioned at this point. Had a good stint with Kilkenny, obviously disappointment losing to Westmeath 1 year, got Kilkenny back to an All-Ireland the following year. So that is huge news for Laois. They look like a team fairly, in a broad sense, moving in the right direction. I think a lot still had to be done in terms of like getting the players physically up to the next level, because they did seem a bit behind. And I mean, obviously, most teams are a good bit behind Limerick at this point. But just to bring them up to that next level, because a couple of the players didn't look like intercounty players, more like sort of club-esque type players physically. But there's plenty of hurling in them. They had a nice style of play. It just felt like it was moving in the direction where things could continue to go well. And it's rare that you see a county board coming out with tweeting out that they're disappointed, and well, they might be. But this is a big, big blow for Laois, and remains to be seen what happens next.